Hi everybody, welcome back to my live flower demonstrations. Today I set it at 8 p.m. in the evening. I think everybody already back home and have your dinner. So everybody should be relaxed. I hope this sharing with you are in a very good condition, harmony condition with you in the Facebook. 大家好, 欢迎来到 Caroline 的花时间。 今天呢，我特地选择在晚上的8点，我想大概大家都已经回到家了，已经用了餐，然后现在应该是很悠闲的，希望大家就看我的那个 live demo。从上两次呢，几次我做的那个作品呢，其实我是想告诉大家，花艺可以多方面的插作，不一定要以就是我们本普通看到的。 也是有多方面，多一个面来做我们的画艺。 Okay, from the past few two or three times demonstrations, I try to make something that a little bit out of box. It's maybe something that we can do it that not expected like normal arrangement, but we still can apply into our kind of principle and element of design. So from there, we will see. I hope that we won't be surprised everybody that a flower can do it that way. But in the international market, there is all possibility. But somehow, if we want back to our education program, that throughout my 25 years of experience, I would this round I would like to share with you how is my syllabus to work on or my flower journey. 这次呢，我要跟大家讲的就是我这么多年来的一些在花艺上的一些学习的一些课程理念。最主要这次我是想跟大家分享的就是欧式的花艺。很多时候呢，欧式的花艺里面呢，我们其实也可以跟我们那个 principle 原理跟那个要素可以结合下来的。 之前我跟大家所讲的一些设计原理啊，设计要素，其实以一个 artist， 以一个设计师，以一个多方面的做这个艺术方面的一个专家，他都应该会至少会有的最基本的一个理念。所以今天我要大多数跟大家讲的是一个 decorative， 这个装饰性的设计。 Today, I would like to emphasize, and one of the syllabus, very important syllabus in the European design is decorative arrangement. So, first thing, I would like to illustrate a little bit what is decorative arrangement. In a professional floral master designer, decorative means that a lot of flowers, foliage of flowers, and they must have a basic form that a clear outline, very symmetrical, that is the three most basic the requirement in our syllabus. 在装饰性画里面呢，我们最主要要注意的就是它看起来是很蓬勃的，很多的花材。然后呢，它呢有一个很明显的一个基本形状，就是我们所讲的一个三角形呢，或者是一个圆形，或者是某些我们的 S 字形。它本身呢也是要需要一个很平衡，怎么讲对称的平衡。 OK， 这个就是我们要今天我要做的一个 decorative 这个装饰性的话。那今天我要做两个 demo， 一个呢就是我们的首先第一个就是我们的 millefleur， 就是千朵花型。千朵花型呢，其实它的时间是在欧洲15到16世纪之间的一个文艺复兴期的法国。 那法国里面呢，有一个就是我们讲 millefleur， 它本身的直接的意思就是千朵花 thousand flowers，OK？So 那边呢，我们从为什么可以引用到现在呢？因为它在很多我们历史方面，很多那些吊毯或者是我们挂在墙壁上的一些毯子，里面都有很多这类的花，那个它里面的一个设计，它就是以背景就是比较绿色的，然后很多小小小点的花。 从这延伸到现在，但OK，现在我现在首先今天我要开始的呢 叫做这个 millefleur， 这很就是看到这次看到我们的花就很多很多类的，这是最主要的，就是很我们刚才所讲的很多类的一个花在我们的装饰性花里面。在我们那个装饰性花材花的设计里面呢，我们主还有一个主要的要注意的，就是很多时候我们会做一些比较古典比较 classical 的一些作品，所以这个千朵花也是其中的一个。 OK, in our decorative flower arrangement, we are most of the time we are referring also in the traditional and classical design. So here today I'm trying to use a traditional, or we call it metal urn for this design. And here we also can see from here we have many types of flower, we can flourish flowers. Okay, so when we start my arrangement,the selection of flowers here you can see is we have this rose. This rose for me is a very classic. The two-tone color, the spray rose. Okay.Normally, when we do something symmetrical, we call it, this will be a cone shape. This one will be a basic form with the cone shaped, okay? 这个今天我们要做就是一个圆锥形。然后我们开始的时候，我们很多时候我们要先决定那花材的高度。我先插一支比较高的花材。因为这个是这个花呢，其实它是 all round to see， 就是四面的看的，所以我们插的时候呢，先决定它的高度。这次我们插花的时候呢，其实这个花材呢，虽然它是一个古典的花型，我们很直接的也还是可以给它直接延伸到我们的那个基本的 principle of design 跟 element of design。至少我们知道，在我们的 principle of design 那个 principle of design 里面呢，它最主要是一个平衡对称的平衡 balance。When we come to the, we will come to this classic, traditional millefleur design. So we still come back to our principle of design where we can have the balance. Very obviously, if we have a cone shape, obviously this will be a very balanced basic form. We will choose one of these flowers.That I like very much here. Okay, I'm gonna get you some short one. To create the form, the shape that I want, the size. So from here, how can I say so much is, oh, short one. I can use back some of the short one.So from here, we see we can have we make sure we get the main flower, or we call it the dominant, one of the dominant flower that we want to get the shape that we want, the size. Okay, then.Here is just roses. We don't need one shot. A lot of people were asking, is it one time we need to finish up all this material at one time? Actually, this is not necessary. We can add on if we find that it's not enough, then later on. Okay. So, We need to have a little bit pointy. Can I have the blue flowers? Ah, okay. Yep. So this is a flower. There's so many flowers this round I have, because this is called 1000 flowers. Definitely, I'm going to select a lot of type of materials. So, refer back to our principle of design, where we have this balance. Obviously, the outlook is a balance. It's a very symmetry cone shape. Then first thing, I need to have some pointy to make it a little bit sharp. Then we're referring to the proportion. As usual, we will know that the proportion, the container with this one is 1.5 to 2.5 times. So by this arrangement, if the flower is light, of course I can make it taller with some light material. Here we have some blue. I need to make it a little bit further for myself to make it work. So first we can use some flowers to create the outline. For me, I like to remove most leaf most time, because I make sure, because this why I remove some of the leaf, because I want the whole arrangement to look light. After I put so many, after the all many so many flower insert inside, so it can be transparent. Okay, and reducing the sleeve also good to help the flowers maintain to get more water. Another thing I need to refer here is another element. We can look back for the element as well. Where is the element that we need to referring the what you call it, the texture? And here, why we have so many flowers? One of the reason that we have so many flowers, because although the flower they look like similar size, but they have a texture. You will find that the texture will be different. Here we are, okay, where we have these carnations. Carnation is totally different texture with the roses. So one of the elements will be the carnation with a different texture in our design. Okay. Here we are, we have this texture of difference. Although its color doesn't look that dominant, but we need it to make it harmony with the different texture in the arrangements. I think this one we need a lot of work, because it's 1,000 flowers. Of course, we don't really going to count whether it is 1,000 stalk of flower, 1,000 flowers, but you must feel that it's look a lot. So basically, for this traditional arrangement, colors is one of the important elements in our design. where you can create something that look a lot with the different type of colors. Here we have using the analogous and then many types of different type of flowers that they really look a lot. So this material is good. Where I use this is for this line, another elements. Another element, very important element in our arrangement. Why? The line, it make it direction, and this in here, the line, it make it a space. They create space as well. Not necessary, you must have everything with flower, but this line is good. The movement, the curvy, you can create more line in the arrangement. So, normally a classic arrangement, you will see a lot of flowers. At the same time, you also need to give them some space according to that our element of design. Oh, this is cute. Oh, this is some flowers. After them turn around, this is good to look at us. If you have the third wheel, it'll be easier for me. Some of the flower you find that it's very light. You can make it a little bit outside from the line. But make sure all material, that particular material they use is open. Here we are with our beautiful material. I got to leave this beautiful one for Riona. Keep this one for Riona. Yep. Here we are. So beside that, almost, not almost, as I almost, we see that, okay, let's see that how many, I need a little bit more rose, okay, a little bit more rose, I'm going to get some rose, okay, that's good, I like this classic colors. If my arrangement is bigger, I can make the whole thing, the whole bunch of rows can put it in. But if let's say my arrangement is in this size, so some of the roses that I need to trim it up. So up here a little bit here. Oh, that's good. Contrast is another element, another principle or elements that we should refer. Where that's why I have this shocking pink a little bit darker pink here to make it interesting. Okay, here more or less we can turn around, we will see whether this is balanced, we should shot some of them shot here, then I got to continue and make sure this is balanced. What else I have? Oh, I have some of this carnations here. A little bit of carnation. Before I carry on with most flowers, actually I can start adding in some of my leaf. Before I carry on. Okay, a lot of time we'll be asking that whether we need to arrange a leaf first or we need to arrange flowers. A lot of people are asking, but a lot of florists, we are doing like, we are just arranging the leaf first because we want to cover the foam or the technical item. But in fact, if let's say you want to present your flower with dominance, for me, definitely I will arrange the most dominant flowers that I like to present to my customer as a first criteria to put it in our arrangement. But when come to a certain level, you can just like put in the leaf, but we need some time to put in. The way we are right time to put is when we are having almost like more than 50% to 60% of the arrangement is the material be in. Now you can put in your leaf material, the forage, okay? 很多时候呢,很多花的都在问, 我什么时候应该先插, 哪一些应该先插叶子呢? 还是先插花? 其实我本身就很喜欢先插我要的花, 因为至少呢, 最主要的花要先呈现出来, 你要放的位置很重要。 然后呢, 你插入差不多的时候呢, 差不多的,差不多有一半或一半上,一半数以上呢, 我们就可以继续插我们的叶材, OK? 因为叶材也是要填补空间, 但不需要太多, OK? 因为这次呢, 这个设计呢, 它本身是带有一些, 欧式的一个花的那个, 所以我选了很多都是四季, 就是比较, 不是在我们 local 的 flower, 就是在四季外国的花, 很多都是进口的, okay? 很多时候这种叶材呢在国外都很多，马来西亚我们现在刚刚是有的是进口，我也忘了它什么名字，但是我觉得在这个作品里面呢用的是非常的好， OK。 有一些花材或者是叶材也好，我们不需要 放得太多，我们是一层层的放进去，不是要只是每次一定要放叶材或者只是花。这个就是我喜欢用的一些很疏松的叶材。我们如果马来西亚的话，我们可以的话，那么就是选用一些疏松也可以，OK。 我们这里可以看到，这里稍微有一点不 balance 了，我们可以再加其他东西下去。 OK， 我们还可以有我们的，还有我们的这个，我还有这个太多东西可以加了，一看起来很多很多花的感觉，我们就要插的看起来很丰满，很丰富。 蓝色太多了，应该放下一面去。很多时候我们在顶部的时候呢，比较细的顶部呢，我们可以插一些比较细的花材。这种线条看起来好像可有可无，但是在这个设计里面呢，其实非常的好，它就会给我们很多的空间，增加了很多松松的感觉。 我们想看起来这有质感的时候呢，我们多加一些这种比较有形状或者是有线条重一点的叶材下去。在插这个时候呢，很多时候呢，为什么会看到这里最主要这个花看起来很多，而且看但还有一个最主要的是它看起来很轻，因为花材太多了，所以我们很要注意，我们选花的时候就要选一些比较细，而且呢它的空间我们要保留，所以叶材方面我们不能够插太大型或者是太重的一个叶材在里面，所以我们选的比较细或者叶那种线条或者是比较蓬松的叶材。因为花太多了，我需要一点点的时间。这个花材，啊，还有这个好的。多加一几根这个下来，给它。Here we are still come back to the millefleur. Why we are selecting so many of the material? Because this is we got to make it feel like 1,000 flowers. So when selection of material, we need to very carefully in the sense that you don't have too big form, but you need to have many. If we have the what they call that, we can put in our element of design that where we have the line, we have the colors, and we have the space, and we have the different textures. Here, almost like, if you like to classify everything from the element design, and you can see everything can be here. Let's say, okay, from here, you can see 1,000 of love. If we want to make it more impact and more emphasis, so we can add in a little bit slightly bigger flowers into this design. So 这次我们要做这个呢，其实看起来其实细细的、松松的一个感觉。但是如果我们要给它加强一点，它要需要有一个 emphasis 一个重点的话，我们可以倒加一点点的大比较大型有形态的一个花进去。但是呢，这个很重要，这个是我们的 Gibra。我们这个 Gibra 呢，这种我今天我很喜欢放它进去，因为它是虚虚的，我觉得蛮我们这里不多，所以我觉得这个可以放进我们这里去。但是记得这个花呢是不能太往外。So in order to emphasize more on our what you call the emphasis in our design, we can add in.Some of the bigger form and a slightly bigger flower, but make sure it is a little bit not too outside, because normally when we arrange some big flower in our arrangements, we will tend to make this one a bit outstanding and become the more what you call that emphasis that make it outstanding. But in this arrangement, millefleur, we make sure that it is a 1,000 flower and this is not the main character. So we're going to reverse it with the other way where the main, the what they call the impact flower, should be lower than the smaller flowers. Here we are. Okay. And I don't make it too dominant. Definitely this flower cannot be dominant, the Gibra. I don't know whether my audience they have any questions on my mille fleurs, Nikki. I need to make it see whether this is balanced, whether this here, okay, here a little bit. There we are. Okay, here another one. Make sure that I would look at this, whether this is balance of the colors. Yep, that's a little bit out. Okay. Can we have some of this? Then we can have, because we want to create some, okay, let's see. So we want to have some texture. We want to see the texture or with some contrast on the texture. Then we have some berry here, hypericum. They have glossy texture here. We compare with the flowers here. We see the difference of this texture where we're going to put it in. Design. There are many space you can put it in. This arrangement looks simple, but not easy to arrange. Do you want to have any tip to how to achieve the similar device? Oh, I see. Yeah, Deborah. It looks simple. Actually, it's a very basic form of arrangements. But you want to achieve into this light and loose effect. Selection of flowers is very important. And not too big flowers. And you need to some, we have line. That way, we come back to our element of design again. Because flowers are our elements. So we need to look into the colors. Of course, if you see the colors, it's we can call it analogous, and we can all a lot of colors here, you can see. Another thing is that we have the different texture, and we have the line, we have the form. Form is where the flower's shape is different, the form of the flowers. So to make it a light effect. I cannot see, can't really see here. Yeah, we can. Well, now I'm going to look for the where we have the space for the materials. Okay, here we have some a little bit note. Okay, we can have a little bit here. Mm-hmm. the flower are flat on. Oh, okay. So just now, somebody can see that the top is a little bit flat because of the small flower that on the top, the directions make it it's different. So we need to take good look of the light. Okay, let me see what else I gotta put in. I got so many things to put in. Oh yeah, my. Okay, almost. Let me see whether this is balanced. Okay, almost. Okay, a little bit. I don't need so many, but I need to see. Okay, let's see. Now, after a while, you got to make yourself turn a little bit, whether that is still in balance, out of shape. Should I? No, I don't. Gonna make it more flowers. Okay, here we are. Then we can add on to make this effect that make it light and loose. I will add in some other material with very light. Okay, we have a little bit of the white chamomile. No, nowadays I think this is just come in this year. The chamomile is quite popular now. We add a little bit of chamomile. I like this flower because this is very loose, look light. Just add a little bit inside. Here, the bottom, we can have some to make it balance. Is it possible to achieve this piece with us? Copiosa and the flowers sticking up, meaning perfect and neat cone. Yes, Deborah, of course we can make it without this line sticking out. Of course we can. We can have other material like this one, the chamomile flowers, something light that you can jump up. But so far I like, because this one, because it's with the curvy, a little bit curvy line, that make it more dramatic and make it more interesting, more dynamic, where it don't affect the whole design as a cone shape. But if you find that, if you find that you want it, make it neat, with too neat, and the outlook is the contents is too, we will find that this is a little bit heavier. Okay, so if you have something light and line and curvy and movement, I'll find that definitely this one look more lightweight, and you will feel that a lot abundant of flowers. Okay, you can achieve by others light material, of course. Here you can see, because the topic today is 1,000 flowers, where we must create the effect that it look a lot a bundle of flowers. So that's the reason we have so many small flowers. Definitely this is more than 1,000 if I count on the particular individual flowers. Okay, almost done. Okay, almost. Here actually, from this arrangement, the main flower is not that, the main material will be covered up with the small material, then you make it lighter. Okay, oh, yep. Oh, this flower need a lot of time and a lot of material. Time is running fast. Okay, here, the first arrangement today. Okay, that is okay. My flowers is not that fresh. Okay, fine. Okay, that's the first, my first arrangement, millefleur, or the drop our classical. Then slow turn the flower, capture close. Okay. Okay, this is my first demonstration on millefleur. 千朵花, 这个是第一个, 今天要做的一个. Okay. This is our decorative, our decoration, flower, syllabus in the main flower. Oh, I can put it in. Okay.